Please, don't let me interrupt. I'm inclined to do a bit of celebrating myself. After all, we've been through a lot together, haven't we?
I should have killed you when I had the chance.
Come now. Is that any way to speak to someone who saved your life? I'd like to propose a toast.
I'll get you a new one, Mrs. Ferguson.
The one in your hand will do fine, Birdsworth.
Oh, you couldn't. I got a cold, and you get all me germs.
I'll take me chances. Here's to your future, ladies. And, especially yours, Smith. There, Lawson.
Cake. Mrs. O'Regan baked it.
What a pity. You'll have to take it back. The party's over. Sorry about that.
Good afternoon, Wentworth Detention Centre. Yes, sir. Thursday the 28th, 9 a.m. Yes, sir. I'll let Mrs. Davidson know. Thank you. Mrs. Davidson, the department just rang to confirm that the VJ will be here the day after tomorrow. Who will I get to do that? One of the senior officers, Mrs. Morris? She's not here at the moment, but I'll see if I can find her. Do you know where Mrs. Morris is, Miss Ferguson?
Yeah, she's in H Block. Why, what's going on?
Mrs. Davidson wants her to inform Smith and Latham that their hearing's been set.
Oh, well, I can do that.
Could you? That'd be terrific. I've got a dinner date and I'm running late on it.
No problem.
The details are all there.
Okay.
Thanks a lot.
Good afternoon, Mrs. Powell.
What are you doing here?
Well, just holding the fort while Heather delivers some memos. The governor called a staff meeting for this afternoon.
Yes, I'm well aware of that.
Oh, then you know all about the little upset yesterday. You know, the governor seems to think...
You're supposed to be convalescing.
Oh, well, I couldn't very well take all that time off while we're so short-staffed here, could I? Besides, the department made it perfectly clear they'd appreciate me back as soon as possible.
Did they?
Oh, don't worry about me. I'm perfectly fit, really.
Well, if anybody needs me, I'm with Mrs. Davidson.
Smith and Latham in their cells?
Yes.
All right.
You know, I could swear something just crept in here and died. It was you, Miss Ferguson.
Your wit is devastating, Smith.
Nice of you to say so, Miss Ferguson.
No doubt you're tested on the VJ tomorrow.
The hearing's tomorrow.
Oh, didn't you know? I must have forgotten to tell you.
What about the solicitor?
What solicitor?
Our solicitor. Has he been informed?
Oh, what a pity. It's too late now. It's after office hours.
We could ring him at home.
Besides, phone calls are a privilege and you're under suspension.
You bitch, you're just doing this on purpose.
Shut up, Chrissy. I think you'll find that phone calls are all right when they have to do with legal representation and Miss Ferguson.
That's not strictly accurate, Smith. I'm sorry, Miss Ferguson, I couldn't help overhearing. You don't have the right to phone your solicitor. But your solicitor does have the right to be informed that your hearing's been set. Isn't that so, Miss Ferguson?
Yes, of course. I was about to do that myself, as a matter of fact.
I bet she doesn't.
Miss Ferguson, you were required to take an oath. Do you have any objections to this on religious or moral grounds?
I do not.
Very well. You'll place your hand on the Bible and repeat after me. I swear by Almighty God.
I swear by Almighty God.
That the evidence that I shall give in this case.
That the evidence I shall give in this case.
Shall be the truth.
Shall be the truth.
The whole truth.
The whole truth.
And nothing but the truth.
And nothing but the truth.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Mrs. Morris?
I want to testify in Smith's defense.
I thought you said none of the officers had anything to add to this inquiry.
Mrs. Davidson doesn't know anything about this. I've only just decided to come forward myself. You see, I was a prisoner here for a while. I know how Officer Ferguson conducts herself when she thinks no one's looking.
I hear you testified against me.
Had your ear to the door, did you?
It's certainly nice to know what you think of solidarity between officers.
You had it coming.
I won't forget this.
You don't scare me. And if I were you, I wouldn't waste my time making threats. Why don't you resign before you're kicked out?
Now, if I were Deputy Governor, I'd...
Which
think...
you're not. Okay. Let's get something straight. I don't like you. You shouldn't even be here. With feelings running so high, I would have kept you on sick leave until things quietened down. However, you are here. So you'll just remember. I'll decide what action to take, and you will follow the orders.
Good. We both want the same thing, then. A quiet, efficiently run prison. Because if there's any more trouble, some of us may not be as good at holding on to our jobs as others. Birdsworth?
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
What's that you're wearing? It's not regulation, is it? Get rid of it.
It's me cardi. I've been wearing it for years and nobody's ever complained before.
That's because things have been slack around here. Now get rid of it.
But I'll get pneumonia.
Too bad.
You'd really enjoy that, wouldn't you?
That's insolence, Birdsworth. You've lost your point for the day.
The what?
So have you, Daniels. Now, Birdsworth, if you're not in regulation uniform next time I see you, you'll be on a charge.
That's not fair!
I'll hold the fort if you feel like a break.
No, it's all right. But, something's come up that needs discussing.
Trouble?
In a word, yes. And if it's not nipped in the bud soon, it'll make our new security measures look like a joke.
Yes, all right. Get to the point, please.
Well, some of the women seem to be getting items that aren't on the buy-up list. Now, that can only happen if someone brings them in from outside.
Well, then... we'll have to screen the visitors a little more carefully, won't we?
I wasn't thinking of visitors.
What is it, Miss Ferguson?
Now, I don't like accusing a fellow officer,
Which officer?
Meg Morris.
Oh, don't be ludicrous. Meg Morris is an officer of the highest integrity. Oh,
but she has done time in here, and she makes no secret of her interest in the women's welfare.
Yes, well, she's been a probation officer in the past.
Yeah, and her attitude counteracts our regulations. The very regulations that you, as Deputy Governor, are trying to enforce.
Fine. I'll speak to Mrs. Morris. Now, if that is all.
I suggest a body search.
Out of the question.
Something wrong?
I insist, Mrs. Powell. The regulations state that an officer can be searched at any time.
What's going on, Colleen?
Well, Miss Ferguson here seems to think that you've been smuggling goods into the women.
And she wishes to conduct a body search on me. Is that correct?
Yes, it is in the regulations.
What utter nonsense. Colleen, you can't seriously
believe...
If you
have nothing to hide, Mrs. Morris, your objection is pointless.
How dare you? How long is this farce going to continue?
It is in the regulations.
The regulations also state that there has to be sufficient reason for a body search. You've no proof to back up your accusations.
My experience as an officer
tells... That cuts both ways. My experience tells me that you're as suspect as I allegedly am, or Mrs. Powell, for that matter. So let's search you whilst we're at it, shall we?
Oh, come on, Meg. This isn't going to get us anywhere.
Quite the contrary. Rules are rules. I'll agree, providing we're both searched. Ferguson first.
Well?
Well, I have nothing to hide. But this exercise is pointless, so I will withdraw my accusation. For the time being. Forget it.
And I'll withdraw mine. But I certainly won't forget it.
You're looking a bit frazzled. The women getting to you?
The women aren't the problem, and you know it.
Oh, yeah. Working to regulations. Suppose it does put pressure on some.
Unnecessary pressure.
Well, you know what they say. If you can't stand the heat, stay out of the kitchen.
Subtlety's never been your strongest point.
No strength, yours, it seems. You're sort of weakened in the face of discipline. You've got no respect for it.
I'm sorry to have to disappoint you, but I've got plenty of strength. I won't back away from you.
Haven't you been doing just that lately?
To a degree, I suppose I have. But it won't last. And in the end, you can bet I'll be waving you goodbye.
You already tried that, and it didn't work.
At the moment, you're manipulating the system. But sooner or later, you'll make a mistake.
Why aren't you working?
Smoker.
On whose authority?
The governor's.
Don't get smart with me, Smith.
We are allowed to break every shift. Mrs. Davidson's orders.
Oh, really? Whose are these?
They're my...
Mustn't grab, Smith. Causes accidents. Transfer Smith and Latham to Barnhurst.
I don't think the department would be too happy about that. Smith already approved that Barnhurst can't hold him.
Well, all right, Latham, then.
That is out of the question. Latham must have access to her daughter, and Barnhurst is too far away. We'll confiscate all the writing materials, see if that will stop them making up their charts.
Governor, I don't think you understand the seriousness of this. Now, surely your loyalty should be to your officers, like Mrs. Powell and myself. We are, after all, the ones at risk.
You have my answer.
Answer? You don't even know the question.
Ferguson,
remember who you are speaking to, and give some very careful thought to your position.
Yes, this is Officer Ferguson from Wentworth Detention Centre. Put me through to the head of department, please. What do you mean, which department? The department. Put me through to Mr. Douglas at once.
Mrs. Davidson wants to see you.
Well, after the exercise period.
Now. Mrs. Morris can take the women out.
Fine. I wanted to see the governor myself. I confiscated these in the laundry.
They're not prison issue.
Well, who processed our friendly social worker into the prison today?
Meg Morris, what are you suggesting?
I'm not suggesting anything, but he should have been searched.
I don't want excuses, Miss Ferguson. Your action was underhand and highly improper.
Governor,
I simply... Don't interrupt! You may have fooled Mr. Douglas for the time being, but quite frankly, I think you're more trouble than you're worth.
My record is spotless.
That means nothing, and you know it. In future, confine your complaints to the correct channels.
I'm very sorry, Governor. I acted in the best interest of the prison and my own personal safety.
Do you expect me to believe that?
If lack of security threatens my safety, then I have every right to act. Now, I believe these were smuggled into the prison this morning by the social worker.
Barry Simmons?
That's right.
He was processed by Meg Morris and he gave them to Paddy Lawson.
I fail to see how this is relevant to what we are discussing.
We are discussing lack of security.
Very well, point taken. This is serious. Lawson is due to be released.
Was due.
Your insubordination is not yet a closed subject, Miss Ferguson, so please do not correct me.
Hi, Miss Ferguson.
Good morning, sir.
Starting to think I should take up residence in this place. I see we've got another mess on our hands with this Lawson girl.
Of course, it's all so unnecessary.
No? What makes you say that?
Well, there was animosity between Mackenzie and the Lawson girl. In my opinion, security wasn't strict enough. But I really shouldn't say any more. It's not my place. I'll let the governor know.
No, Miss Ferguson, please feel free. If I had a dozen officers like you, my job would be much easier.
Speaking of which, Sarah, there's something here that I think you should have a look at.
What, more trouble?
Let's say another breach of security involving an officer.
Meg Morris. Well, it's going to take me some time to read this properly.
Well, it may be some time before the governor can see you. Perhaps you'd like to go to the staff room. You'll have some privacy there.
Oh, yes, yes, I'll do just that. Thank you.
Smith, I want to talk to you.
Did you hear something?
Oh, yeah. It was me. I had baked beans for brekkie.
Smith?
Hey, Maxine.
Yes?
One of the screws is breaking the rules again.
Oh, no. Well, that's what rules are made for, B.
Excuse me.
You don't think this ridiculous strike is going to solve anything? Mrs. Morris resigned because she'd have been fired otherwise. You're fighting the department on this one.
Then you'd better hope we win, hadn't you?
Suppose and they don't open the gate.
We will cross that bridge when we come to it.
All right. Hello.
I understand you have spoken to Mrs. Morris and she has explained the situation.
Oh, all right, Mrs. Davidson. So the situation has changed since we first decided to go on strike. It was bad enough when we thought Mrs. Morris was being forced out. But now we know that she was only one step ahead of the firing squad, led, of course, by Miss Ferguson.
This has nothing to do with Miss Ferguson. There is nothing more I can do to meet your demands, so I suggest you go back to work or you will be penalised.
Then it's only fair to warn you, Mrs. Davidson. If Mrs. Morris leaves this prison, so does Miss Ferguson, one way or another.
Know anything about this, Smith?
No.
Get rid of it before the governor finds out about it. Mackenzie's been rostered in the laundry, Smith. Find something for her to do. So,
they let you out?
Yeah.
Jacko, little corridor. I'm surprised you had the nerve to come back in here after what you've been having. One more lousy day and she would have been out of here if it hadn't been for you.
I've got no fight with you, Smith.
Oh, like hell you haven't.
Hey! Oh. Get your lousy oh. You what the fuck? Let us in mind.
Go ahead, Smith. What are you waiting for? There's a spare cell in solitary.
Yeah, but B didn't start it, Miss Ferguson. Nola kicked her right in the gut.
Oh, I wouldn't say that, Daniels. I'd have seen it if she did. I've been standing outside all the time and I never saw a thing. Go ahead, Smith. Don't let me stop you.
Well, well, well. Looks like the freak's got herself a new girlfriend.
Hmm. So you got a watchdog?
What?
Ward. I just sent her away. Heard you got a bit roughed up. How come the governor sent you back for another dose?
She wasn't going to. But there was no way I was going back to solitary.
Oh? How'd you persuade her?
I told her you did it.
You what?
Don't worry. I kept your name out of it. I just dropped a few hints. Can I help it if the governor and Mrs. Powell jump to all the wrong conclusions?
Don't you try that again, Mackenzie, because you'll regret it.
And what'll you do, Miss Ferguson? Charge me? The longer I stay in here, the less chance I have of going back across the Nullarbor. And that suits me fine.
I don't suppose you're going to tell me what this is all about.
Extra duties for insubordination. The PRG have given us a couple of cartons of books. You can unpack them.
Working in the library? Mm-hmm. It's a pretty cushy job for punishment, isn't it?
You know me, Smith. An old softy. Go on, move.
G'day, B.
Well, well, well. So this is it. Finally got the nerve, eh? Get lost.
B?
Get out.
Right. Miss Ferguson. Oh, I got
then go, Quinn.
Yeah, but...
Move it.
Help you, Miss Ferguson? Maybe you'd like to take out a book.
Here's one for you. Leathercraft for the enthusiast.
What's going on? Quinn seemed rather eager to get out of here.
Oh, well, you know, two's company, three's a crowd.
She didn't quite fit in.
You don't look too well, Miss Ferguson.
Just get on with the books.
Yes, Miss Ferguson. Now, what was it we were up to, Nola? Hobbies, wasn't it?
I'd like to speak to the officer in charge, if I could.
I'm in charge. Senior Officer Ferguson.
Yes, I want to speak to my wife, Colleen Powell. I'm her husband.
Oh, sorry, Mr. Powell, but the Deputy Governor isn't on duty.
Oh, I see. Well, maybe you can help...
If I can.
Yes, well, I don't exactly know where she is.
Oh, I'd have thought she'd be at home, at Meg Morris's place. But I expect you've already tried there.
No, I haven't. Thanks.
Don't mention it, Mr. Powell. How the new sleeping arrangements? You and Colleen getting along cosily?
It's none of your business.
Maybe not. I must say, I never expected you two to set up house together. You've had your little tiffs in the past, haven't you?
Nothing serious. We get on quite well, actually.
Oh, well. It's early days yet, isn't it? We'll just have to wait and see, won't we?
Well, you can wait as long as you like. It suits us both, just for now.
Right, Quinn, search time. Oh, come on, Quinn, you know the rules by now. Into the showers. Nice indeed.
That's mine.
Oh, no, it isn't. The only money coming to you is what you've earned.
Well, I earned that too.
Did you now? Perhaps you'd like to tell me how you earned it.
What's the difference? I'm getting out of here anyway. I've been working as cover for Nola Mackenzie.
Mackenzie, eh? I might have known. What's she up to?
Well, you know them buy-up goods that went missing? That was Nola. I don't know where she stashed them, but she's been flogging them off at a profit. That $40 is my cut.
And this is my cut. Right. Now, you'd better hide that, Quinn. Wouldn't want to lose it, would you? Quinn's ready to sign for her wages, Mrs. Morris. They tell me you're going to be a guest here for quite some time.
That's right.
Well, I think that we should come to an arrangement.
Don't tell me you've got to pay for it these days.
Shut your mouth. You know what this is, and you know where it came from. Your front lady wasn't too eager to part with it, but I managed to persuade her for the good of her health.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, I'm talking about a little corner store full of buy-up goodies. And all the other neat little transactions you've been involved in since you came here. I'm talking about a prison officer who just might turn a blind eye. And who just might make it possible for you to replenish your stock at a price. 50% of the take.
You're talking double Dutch.
All right, Mackenzie. We'll play it your way for now. We've got plenty of time. But sooner or later, you'll find it much more profitable to accept my rules. Daniels.
What have I done?
Why isn't Birdsworth taking the basket around? It's her job.
Yeah, well, Lizzie was feeling a bit tired, Miss Ferguson, so I took over for her.
Tired, eh? And the poor old thing wasn't up to pushing a heavy basket around.
Oh, fair go. How do you reckon you'll be when you're her age?
Any more remarks like that, Daniels, and you'll be around to find out. I thought so.
What are you going to do?
Just go, Daniels.
You mean you're not going to put me on report?
I said go. So there's no trading in progress?
Beats me.
You have a choice, Mackenzie. I'm feeling particularly generous today. Now, either you let me in on your little enterprise, or I take this list and this money and you, and we all pay a little social call on the governor.
Oh, come off it. You've got nothing on me and you know it.
I don't think I'd have any trouble getting a few facts out of Daniels. She doesn't have a very big vocabulary, but it's big enough to lag on you.
Nobody lags around here. You ought to know that.
Listen, if I stage a search, how long do you think it'd take to tear this wing apart and expose your little treasure trove? And then you'd be finished. Instead of which, it could be the beginning.
You finish me. And I promise you I'll take a few people with me. Screws included.
You don't impress me, Mackenzie. I've dealt with the likes of you for years. So, it's over. Either we're partners, or you've just made yourself the worst enemy you'll ever have. How was your little chat with the governor?
All right, I guess. She just gave me a rundown on the rules.
Is that all?
Yes. What's she like, anyway?
You will refer to the governor as Mrs. Davidson or governor at all times, understand?
Oh, I see. Sorry.
Right. Now, unpack your things and make up your bed. Tomorrow you go on work roster.
Can't sleep, young. Still, I suppose it's understandable. Must be a worrying time for you. But then you're lucky you've got Mrs. Powell here to look after you.
What do you mean?
Oh, housekeepers. Meeting your husband after work.
When?
Didn't you know? Oh, I saw him during my dinner break. Oh, your husband looked real good too. All dressed up. Going out for dinner by the looks of it.
You're lying.
Oh, now, don't get upset, young. I'm sure they'll be thinking of you. In fact, I'll bet Mrs. Powell brings you in a doggy bag in the morning.
What the hell do you think you're up to?
Just having a coffee break. Why, something gone wrong?
Oh, cut it out. You know damn well what I mean. Janice Young.
Young. Oh. Oh, yeah, that's right. She gets out the day after tomorrow, doesn't she? Too bad. Still, you had a little time together, I suppose.
Listen, what happens outside of this prison is none of your business. And I wouldn't start causing trouble if I were you, if you don't know the facts.
Oh, but I saw the facts. So don't preach to me, Mrs. Powell.
You think you saw the facts, and as usual, you are wrong.
And why are you so upset?
Because I want to know why you did it.
Well, I happen to think that the women have a hard enough time in here as it is without their husbands playing up on the outside.
Oh, God. Concern for the prisoners now, is it?
Yeah, that'll do. Besides, if I wanted to keep it a secret, I'd hardly meet him in broad daylight at the front gates.
And I wouldn't go around telling tales if I was as eager as you to have officer solidarity.
Oh, but I'm not. Not anymore. That sort of thing's too one-sided in here.
It's a warning. Keep away from Janice Young.
Or what? You'll tell the governor? Oh, that should be very interesting.
You're doing a fine job. I'm sorry about this, but of course you understand it's the only way we could get to see you without raising suspicion.
Well, Heather, the governor wants to see you. She said to take the building specifications for D block and your notebook. And look, I can only stay for 10 minutes, so don't be too long. Hello. Yes, clerk of courts, please. Yes, it's Wentworth Detention Centre here. I wonder if you can help me. There seems to be some confusion over the sentencing of one of our prisoners. Clark. Gillian Clark.
What's the problem?
What do you know about Jill Clark?
Like I told you, she's a bit nosy, but she's doing a uni thesis on prisons. Why?
I've been doing some checking. There doesn't seem to be any record of her trial. As far as the courts are concerned, she doesn't exist.
A spy?
It looks that way. So I'm warning you, Mackenzie. If anyone finds out that I'm involved in your smuggling racket, you're going to have more trouble than you can handle.
You're a bit late, I'm afraid. Smith found out.
What?
Yeah. And she told the other women. So I reckon you're the one who's in trouble, Miss Ferguson. Because when Clark gets out of solitary, she's going to find out too. Yeah. I reckon you've got big trouble.
Now, come on. Hurry it up. I don't want you in here while I'm eating.
Excuse me. Have you been on duty all day? Can you tell us anything about B. Smith's escape?
No, I can't.
Well, what's the department's feeling on what's happened?
No comment.
Well, it seems Smith had no trouble in getting out this afternoon. Yeah, she's well disguised from the description we've been given.
Look, I have had the misfortune of seeing you on television, and I'm not interested in your sensational garbage. Now, leave me alone.
I think we'll edit that out, Max.
Yes, well, the prisoner has escaped and is still at large. Being sorry isn't going to help.
No, sir.
Mrs. Davidson's going to have to make out a full report on this. It's not going to look very good in your record.
I realise that, sir.
Well, I must say I think it's of great pity. You're copybook material up to now. But this matter can't be overlooked.
No.
Yes. Just a moment, Mrs. Powell. Julian Clark is in reception.
I'll tell them to send her through.
Would you send her to my office, please?
That'll be all, Miss Ferguson.
Will it, sir? I mean, is this the end of the matter?
I shouldn't think so. I'll be discussing it with the board. You'll be informed in due course.